Bless the Lord, my soul. Lord, my God, how great you are.
How many are your works, O Lord? If wisdom you have made them all, in wisdom you have made them all.
Wisdom.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans.
Let us be attentive.
Brothers and sisters, my heart's desire, my prayer to God for the Israelites is that they may be saved. Indeed, I can testify that they are zealous for God, though their zeal is unenlightened, unaware of God's justice and seeking to establish their own. They did not subject themselves to the justice of God. Christ is the end of the law. Through him, justice comes to everyone who believes. Moses writes of the justice that comes from the law. The one who observes the law shall live by it. But of the justice that comes from faith, he says, do not say in your heart, who shall go up into heaven? That is to bring Christ down. Or who shall go down into the abyss? That is to bring Christ up from the dead. What is it he does he say? The word is near you, on your lips and in your heart. That is the word of faith which we preach. For if you confess with your lips that Jesus is Lord, and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. Faith in the heart leads to justification. Confession on the lips to salvation.
Receive you in your gospel. Wisdom be attentive.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Go forth, triumph and reign for the sake of truth and meekness and justice.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
the snake had the firefly quartered, and the firefly knew that she was about to be consumed by the snake, so the firefly turned around and faced the snake and said to the snake, "Before you eat me, I want to ask you three questions. Number one, do you realize that if you eat me, you'll probably get sick and maybe even die because I'm poisonous?" And the snake said, "Yes, I do." And the firefly then asked the second question. The second question was, "Tell me, have I done anything to offend you?" And the snake said, "No." And then the firefly asked the third question, "Well, then why do you want to eat me?" And the snake replied without hesitation, "Because you are beautiful and you shine and everyone loves you. When people see me, they run. When people see you, they smile. I hate the way you shine," said the snake to the firefly. Well, friends, the moral of the story is that some people find it unbearable to see others shine more than they do. And maybe, you know, maybe, just a little maybe, sometimes that could be true in us. Knowingly or unknowingly, maybe we kind of, you know, strike out in our thoughts or even with our words like, you know, snakes. If people are perceived by us to be happier or more popular or more successful than we are, pray God we catch ourselves and correct ourselves so that we don't stay in that frame of mind for a long time, because we do not want pride or jealousy or envy to get the best of us, do we? No, that's right. Well, here's something to think about, all of you who answered no. You know, we learn from the Holy Scriptures and from the teaching of our church and from our Lord himself in the gospel reading that Deacon Charles just chanted today that there are other creatures made by God, creatures that we call the fallen angels or the demons, or the devils, who are filled with pride, with jealousy, and with envy, so much so against us that they'll do anything to pull us away from God. Here's something else to think about. In the gospel reading today that Deacon Charles chanted, you hear about how Jesus removes demons from a man and allows them to enter into a herd of swine. And all this happens before the herd goes into a the demons go into a herd of swine and they jump off a cliff. Remember that statement? It's a rather significant statement because it reminds us when the devils said to Jesus, "Have you come to meddle with us, Son of God, before the appointed time?" Remember what Deacon chanted that? It's just one small little line written in a whole famous story that we read numerous times throughout the year. "Have you come to meddle with us, Son of God, before the appointed time?" That reminds us, friends, that God gives the demons permission to tempt us, but only for a while. Think about that. Now, there's a man, a saint in our church by the name of John Damascene. Anybody ever hear of St. John Damascene? Hey, do we have an icon of John Damascene in our church? No, I thought we'd be probably somewhere.
I do have an icon, but it's
okay. St. John Damascene, I think you know he's written some beautiful hymns in our church, but he's also somebody who's written about demons, and here's what he has to say about the devils. Kind of an expert on this sort of thing. He said, "Among the angelic powers, heavenly powers, the angels, the chief of the terrestrial order, the one whom God entrusted the entire task of looking after the whole earth, was not evil by nature. He had not received any trace of evil from his creator. He was good.
prayers and petitions that we call to mind and give to him this day.
May our Lord God hear all our private prayers and grant them in petition most helpful to peace and to salvation. May the Lord God remember all those who are sick or suffering, hospitals and need his mercies, and all you Christians of the true faith always now and forever.
Creator of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible.
prophets and apostles, saying, Take ye, this is my body which is broken for you, for the remission of sin.
Down upon this speaker, to thy grace, and again.
Tuesday, because then we can compile a ballot. After we have the ballot, we'll ask everyone to vote. The vote will be private. I will be the only one who sees the responses. So hopefully by this time next week or shortly thereafter, we will have a renewed chairperson. It's something I really think is important for us to do. You might say to yourself, oh, we don't need a chairperson. Everybody kind of knows what to do. Well, that is very, very true, but it is practical and very helpful to have one person or two that we can go to, I can go to, anyone can go to for a definitive answer who knows the rules and the regulations and is kind of up to date on stuff. So we found that to be helpful in the years past. So we want to do something like that.